श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। नमस्कारम्। A very good evening to all of you who have gathered here. After almost a year's hiatus in live stage performances, this is Prayatnam's first live stage program, which is also being webcast. This is Nritya Sandhya, an evening of dance. It gives me immense pleasure to have Kalaimamani Srimati Jayanti Subramaniam as our honorable chief guest. She is also a member of our advisory committee. I also welcome Dr. Shashirekha Ramohan, our core committee member, and also all the dance enthusiasts who have assembled here and who all are watching the live telecast. A few words about the activities of Prayatnam. Prayatnam is an organization of committed dancers and teachers dedicated to the idea of illumination in both the aspects of theory and practice of dance. Prayatnam broadens the scope of learning by conducting workshops and lecture demonstrations to the members and their students. Prayatnam conducts diploma courses for levels from 1 to 6 with a specific syllabus and assessment with graded certification by conducting practical and theory exams to the enrolled students in various centers. The toppers of level 6 and lateral level 2 are also chosen to perform kacheris in the festivals facilitated by Prayatnam. It is a journey that started 12 years ago by Srimati Dr. Srilata Vinod, Dr. Shashirekha Ramohan and Dr. S. Divyaseda, which later became a huge tree with three more senior teachers joining the core committee, Dr. Lakshmi Ramaswamy, Dr. Himaja Atul Kumar and Dr. Sujata Mohan as the core team. Now, Prayatnam also has 150 members spread over Chennai, Madurai, Coimbatore, Kanchipuram and in Hyderabad, Singapore, Muscat and USA. It is noteworthy that during the pandemic situation also, Prayatnam team was very active in social media, in the YouTube channel and the Instagram page by Prayatnam family, conducting online kacheris, paper presentations and workshops in Talam and Abhinaya by senior exponents in dance. I personally was lucky to be part of the learning process to attend the Talam course taken by Sri Swami Malai Suresh and our honorable chief guest, Srimati Jayanti Subramaniam. The online courses have benefited all the members and their students spread over various parts of the world. In today's Nritya Sandhya, first, we will be watching an exclusive lecture demonstration by Srimati Jayanti Subramaniam, followed by that, a dance recital by M. Shriya, a level 6 topper who is a disciple of Srimati Lata S. Rajagopalan and Srimati Madhuri Balram. I'm sure this lecture demonstration will definitely benefit all of us who are eagerly waiting to work and learn more on the nuances of Abhinaya. I also want to mention that Prayatnam will be conducting an online contest based on the lecture demonstrations, the link which has already been shared in Instagram page and through other social media apps. A brief introduction about our honorable chief guest, Kalaimamani Srimati Jayanti Subramaniam. She is a senior disciple of Padma Shri Adyar K. Lakshman sir, Padma Bhushan Kalanidhi Narayanan and Bhagavatalu Sita Rama Sharma. Deeply rooted in tradition, her art is known for its classical purity and deep emotive quality. She runs her institution Kala Darshana in Chennai, where training is imparted in the theory and practice of Bharatanatyam to young aspirants in India and from abroad. As a teacher, performer and choreographer, Srimati Jayanti Subramaniam combines the best of tradition with a creative touch, all of her own. Endowed with a rich experience of over 4 decades, she has produced an instructional DVD for the basics of Bharatanatyam, which is a ready reckoner for young students. She is the recipient of several awards, including the prestigious Kalaimamani of the State Government of Tamil Nadu. She is an empaneled artist of the ICCR and an A-grade artist of the Doordarshan. She is the only Bharatanatyam artist who had the privilege of performing in the Sziget Festival in Budapest. She has enthralled visiting foreign dignitaries, delegates and students from several universities abroad with her lecture demonstrations and Bharatanatyam recitals. With immense pleasure and gratitude, I welcome you, Madam, onto the stage to present today's lecture on Varnam, Hues and Shades. Namaskaram. At the outset, I would like to thank Prayatnam for having invited me to do this lecture demonstration on Padavarnams. The artists accompanying me for this evening's lecture demonstration: Kalaimamani Srimati Radha Badri, vocal; Kalaimamani Sri Nellaidi Kannan on the mridangam; Sri R. Kalayarasan on the violin; and my daughter Sumitra Subramanya on the natuvangam. Though the subject of Padavarnams is an exhaustive one, I will try, in the time allocated to me, to highlight some of the salient features of the Padavarnam with respect to the practical aspect. Varnams are compositions in the Carnatic music repertoire that bring out the characteristic patterns of a particular raga or scale. They are complex vocal exercises in Carnatic music, designed to develop voice culture and a good control over rhythm. Varnams essentially capture the raga bhavam,
the ranjaka prayogas and the vishesha sancharas of a particular ragam. Dhatu and janta prayogas are very typical of a varnam. While a varnam is traditionally sung as the opening number in a Carnatic music concert to serve as a warm-up for musicians, it constitutes the central and most important piece in a Bharatanatyam repertoire. Now let us look at the musical structure of the varnam. The musical structure essentially consists of two segments, the Purvangam and the Uttarangam. The Purvangam is further divided into three segments, the Pallavi, Anupallavi and Muktaiswaram. Pallavi is the foremost section of the varnam and is sung with lyrics or sahityam. Anupallavi is an extension of the lyrics of the Pallavi. The Muktaiswaram is a section which is sung purely with syllables and swaras. In Padavarnams, we have lyrics corresponding to the Muktaiswaram. The Uttarangam again has two segments, Charanam and Ethikadaswaras. The Charanam of a Varnam is also known by other names such as Ethikada Pallavi, Upapallavi and Chitta Pallavi. The Charanam is sung with lyrics. The Chitta Swara or Ethikada Swara is sung completely with swarams. In a Padavarnam, there are lyrics which correspond to the Charanam swarams. The swaras occur in several groups or stanzas, and we may have as many as four or five groups of swaras, and in some varnams we have multiple charanams too. In olden days, the varnam had an epilogue which was known as anubandham. This additional part follows the charanam and the ethikada swaras and is sung with lyrics or sahityam, thus leading back to the Muktaiswara or the Pallavi line itself. It is found more often in the varnams of yesteryears and less prevalent in the newer varnams. The varnams fall under three main categories: the Thana Varnam, the Padavarnam and the Daruvarnam. The Thanavarnams are frequently used as the opening number in a Carnatic music concert. The lyrics are few and structured closely around the swarams of the varnam, and the syllables fall clearly on defined beats of the talam. Most Thanavarnams are in Rettakale Adi Talam and Atatalam, and the main, the Sthayi Bhavam is Bhakti Rasa. As for instance, the Viriboni Varnam in Bhairavi Ragam set to Atatalam. Padavarnams are also known as Chauka Varnams or Atavarnam. The Padavarnam is in slow tempo, giving the dancer ample scope to explore the emotional content which is deeply embedded in the composition. The key difference between the Thanavarnams and Padavarnams is in the lyrical aspect. While Thanavarnams are primarily considered as vocal exercises in a particular raga, the Padavarnams have more lyrical content. The main difference is that the Pallavi and the Anupallavi in a Padavarnam sound more like a Padam. Examples of Padavarnams that are commonly performed: the Rupamu Juchi in Todi Ragam in Adi Talam, a composition of Muthuswami Dikshidar; Swami Nanunda Nadimai in Nate Kurunji and set to Adi Talam, a composition of Papanasam Shivan; Mohamana Enmeedhu in Bhairavi Ragam and Rupakathalam, a composition of the Tanjore Quartet. Coming to the Daru Varnam, the Daru Varnam has Jati passages interspersed with the Swaras in the Muktai Swaram segment. The Ethikada Swarams do not have corresponding Sahityam. A classic example of the Daru Varnam is Mate Malayadhvaja Pandya Samjate, composed by Sri Harikeshanallur Muthaya Bhagavatar, who was a musician in the court of Sri Krishnaraja Udayar, the Maharaja of Mysore. We also have the genre known as Swarajatis, and it is believed that the Swarajati preceded the Varnam. The architect of the Swarajati as a musical form is Melattur Veerabhadraya, who lived in the 18th century. His Swarajati in the Ragam Husseini is the earliest example of a Swarajati, and following this, Shyama Shastri has composed many a Swarajati. A classic example of a Swarajati commonly seen in dance performances is A Mayaladera in Ragam Husseini and Rupakathalam. The Swarajatis used for Natyam are very close to a Varnam in structure. The difference is that instead of Muktai Swarams, we have Muktai Swarajati, and this is sung in two tempos. Many Swarajatis have small exclamatory expressions whose origin may be traced to the Prabandhams, as for instance, Auraura in the Husseini Swarajati, Pangana Mayile, which is again an exclamatory phrase in Sakiye in the Velayal in Ananda Bhairavi. Now coming to the tackling of a Varnam in Natyam. The Varnam is the piece de resistance in a Bharatanatyam performance. It is a touchstone, as it were, for the dancer's ability in both Nrittam and Abhinayam. While the musical structure of a Varnam in Natyam remains the same, the presentation is quite different. The Varnam begins typically with the Trikala Jati. The lines of the Pallavi and Anupallavi are delineated through Abhinaya. And between the lines of the Pallavi and Anupallavi, we have intervening Jatis. A crisp Aridhi at the end of the Jati gives an extra flourish to the Nritta segments. Thereafter, we have the Muktai Swaram and the Sahityam, and the Purvangam segment ends with a Sarpanade followed by a Thattimettu. A major challenge while composing or performing a Varnam lies in adeptly balancing the Nritta and Abhinaya segments so as to ensure that a seamless thread is established from beginning to end. I shall demonstrate a small segment from the Bhairavi Varna Mohamana of the Tanjore Quartet, choreographed by my guru. The jatis that he has composed are crisp, catchy, and measured, lending themselves to the musicality, the sahityam, and sthayi of the varnam. The transition from nritta to abhinaya and vice versa should be smooth, and the dancer needs to get into the mood of the varnam right from the word go. Mohamana in the Ragam Bhairavi set to Rupakathalam.
Oh, jam ra ta jam sa re ta jam sa sa re ta jam da ri ta ka ta sa jam sa ta jam sa re ta jam sa ta re ta jam da ri ta ka ta sa jam sa ta jam sa re ta jam sa ta re ta jam da ri ta ka ta sa jam sa ta jam da ri ta jam sa ta re ta jam da ri ta ka ta sa jam sa ta jam da ri ta jam sa ta re ta jam da ri ta ka ta sa jam sa ta jam da ri ta jam sa ta re ta jam da ri ta ka ta sa jam sa ta jam da ri ta jam sa ta re ta jam da ri ta ka ta sa jam sa ta jam da ri ta jam sa ta re ta jam da ri ta ka ta 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 ta
coming to the Abhinaya segment of the Padavarna, though the lyrics in a Varnam are akin to that of a Padam, the way the hands are done in a Varnam is quite different from the way it is done in a Padam. A certain degree of restraint and stylization is required in the Varnam in order to avoid disparity between the Abhinaya and Nritta segments. Let us now take the line Swami Nananda Nadime from the Nate Kurinji Varnam of Papanasam Shivan and see how we would do it in a Varnam and how we would do it if it were to be rendered as a Padam. All of you will be familiar with the padam Netrandi Neerathile. Now let us see how this line can be interpreted if it were a padam and if it were a varnam.
Netrandi Neerathile Thank you.
The Margam, as we practice today, was designed by the Tanjore Quartet in the 19th century AD. They composed exquisite padavarnams, replete with shringaram. The purpose of these compositions was to extol the deity in the temple to which the devadasis were attached, or to sing the praise of the kings and the patrons in the courts. That was a different era. The purpose of the art was different, the society was different, and the audience it was aimed at was different. However, these musical masterpieces are relevant even today, as the emotion of Shringara, which is the mainstay of these padams, is universal. Composers who came after the Tanjore Quartet, in keeping with the need of the hour, came up with varnams that were predominantly bhakti-oriented, and Shringara was underplayed to facilitate easy learning process for beginners, and also in keeping with the need of the hour. The renowned guru, Sri K. N. Dandayadapani Pillai, with his in-depth knowledge of both music and dance, has composed many beautiful varnams appropriate to different age groups of dancers. We have composers like Papanasam Shivan, Vidwan Madurayan Krishnan, Sri Lal Guruji Jayaraman, whose varnams abound in bhakti and madhura bhakti. It is important to select varnams that are appropriate to the age of the dancer, and also choreograph the hands in keeping in mind the age of the dancer. Let us take the Danyasi varnam of Papanasam Shivan, Neendamayam. The Pallavi reads, Neendamayam Seidal, Nyayam Danu, Dayanidhiye. And the Anupallavi says, Payum Maran, Ambinale Tumburum Pavaye, Para Kannal Paramalinnum. The predominant emotion is Shringara, because the lines of the Anupallavi explicitly speak of how the Nayika is tormented by the arrows of Cupid. But when my guru composed it, he composed it for children within the age group of 12 and 14, and so the Shringaram had to be underplayed. But as we grow older, it is important to revisit the composition and make our delineation age appropriate. I will now show just two hands from the Neendamayam.
Oh,
The Varnam in general and the Purvangam in particular gives ample scope for the dancer to improvise. It is here that we arrive at the important aspect of Sanchari Bhavam. Sanchari Bhava is very often mistaken for mere storytelling. Sanchari Bhavas are fleeting emotions, transitory emotions that appear and disappear in quick succession, serving to strengthen the Sthayi Bhava, or the predominant emotion underlying a composition. Now, while elaborating on a line, it is important to look into these factors. What is the word or line that I am going to elaborate? Why? How? And how long? Take the words Sakiye in the Velayil Jalam Seyyade. The primary meaning is, O friend, at this time do not play with me thus. Here there is no need to go into an elaborate description of the Sakhi, as she is not the main subject matter. The main idea of the Varnam is the love experienced by the Nayika for Rajagopala Swami of Minnarkudi, which was further enhanced by the beauty of the surroundings and the time on hand. So the word Sakiye can just be interpreted as, O beautiful friend, my dear friend, O compassionate friend, O discreet friend. And in the Velayil can be interpreted as a beautiful time, a time when the flowers are in full bloom, the time when the gentle breeze is blowing, a time when everything in nature is happily united, a time when the Nayika is brimming with love for her Lord, a time when she is tormented by the arrows of Cupid, that she cannot eat or sleep because she is constantly thinking of her Lord. And the possibilities are endless. Now, how am I going to elaborate a line in the Varnam? There are different ways of elaborating on a particular line. As a general rule, we begin with doing the Padartha and Vakyartha. Then we read between the words and between the lines. And of course, as dancers, we love to tell a story given the chance. I shall demonstrate the line Bhumi Pugarum Shivakami Magirum Balan from the Purvi Kalyani Varnam of Guru Dandayatha Panipillai. Here I will be showing the birth of Muruga. But what is important is not the story as such, but how it enhances the feeling of love and the sense of awe that the Nayika feels for Lord Muruga. It is also important that at the end of the story we connect it to the line that we are elaborating upon. And it is always good to bear in mind the alavu of the story. We just can't go on and on with it. Oh, Was one way of elaborating on a line where we narrated just one story. Now let us take a line from the Kamas Varnam of the Tanjore Quartet, Samiye Azhaithu Vaadi. In the second line of the Pallavi, The Nayika tells her friend, Samanya Durai Alladi, Sakiye Avar. Oh my friend, he is no ordinary person. In my demonstration of this line, I will be making references to several stories that speak of the greatness of Lord Shiva. But each story finishes within a line. Again, what is important is not the story, but the feeling it invokes in the Nayika in love. We need to build up upon those emotional layers.
Oh,
Sometimes a line may not give room for storytelling, but may offer scope for building up layers of emotions. I shall now demonstrate a line from the magnum opus of the Tanjore Quartet, the Navaragamalika Varnam, Sami Nini Kori Nanura. The line Prema Niraga Tanjapuri Vasa. O Lord of Tanjapuri, my love for you excels.
Oh,
Some varnams lend themselves to so many interpretations. I was looking into the Pallavi of the beautiful Charukesi Varnam of Lalgudi Shri G. Jayaraman. Innum yen manam ariyadavar pol irundidal nyayama yadava madhava. This is usually done with Madhura Bhakti or Shringaram. I thought I would take a bit of artistic license and demonstrate this line as the Ashtanayikas. I will be portraying the Nayika in this order: the Abhisarika, Swadhinapatika, Vasakasajja, Virahotkantita, Vipralabdha, Khantita, Kalahantarita and Proshitapatika.
Yeah.
To the Purvangam. Of course, after the Pallavi and Anupallavi, we have the Muktaiswaram and the Muktaiswaram Sahityam. And while transitioning from the Purvangam to the Uttarangam, it is very important to hold on to the Sthayi Bhavam. My student Manasa will demonstrate a small segment from the Uttarangam of Neendamayam Varnam of Papanasam Shivam, where my guru has incorporated episodes like Kalinga Nardanam and Govardhana Giridhara in the Arudis of the Charanam. Ayar Kula Deepame.
Yeah.
I will now demonstrate in brief the Uttarangam of the Purvi Kalyani Varnam of Dandayatha Panipillai. The Charanam is Solladi Manam Kallodi Jalam Sheivadenadi. But every time you come back to the Charanam after doing an Ettukada Sahityam, the emotion behind the line changes. In the last Charana Sahityam, I have used a back walk for the Sarpanadam. I will be demonstrating just the Abhinaya segment due to want of time.
Yeah.
I conclude my presentation this evening by stating that the Padavarnam is something more than the sum of its parts. It is not just putting together a few jatis, a few hands, a few tatimetas and aridis. It is a homogeneous blend of music, movement and emotions in different proportions, all culminating in rasanubhavam, which is the purpose of the arts. I take this opportunity to thank the accompanying artists of this evening, Srimati Radha Badri, Sri Nelledi Kannan, Sri R. Kalayarasan, and Sumitra Subramanian, and my student Manasa for taking part in the demonstration. I also take this opportunity to express my gratitude to Prayatnam for having invited me to present this lecture demonstration. I enjoyed it as much working on it. Thank you.
Vinabhinaya is an expression of poetry. A connoisseur like me can never have enough of it. But due to want of time, this beautiful session is coming to an end. And I express my sincere gratitude on behalf of Prayatnam to Srimati Jayanti Subramanyam. Thank you, Akka. I now request the core committee member, Dr. Shashirekha Ram Mohan, to honor Srimati Jayanti Subramanyam and the team of musicians here.